Welcome back to the Legend series, everybody. Ahead of us is Vexed Gaming that we didn't actually get to take a look at yesterday. So it's going to be definitely interesting to see how they perform here in the Legend series. And they will face off against Euronics Gaming, who have just taken down Playing Ducks. And that's going to be really interesting. And one of the matches off the screen was a pretty quick match. Also, at the same time you were casting the game alongside with Vincent, it was 16-6, if I'm not mistaken, in favor of Tricked over Legends. So Legends finally lost a match in their group.
Oh, they did. But yeah, they look really strong. But we talked about this. Tricked, with their outstanding performance against Outlaws, I mean, 16-0. Yeah. We know what shape these guys are in. And not even Legends could shut them down.
Yeah, that's the thing. Tricked up really strong, and also 16-0, 16-6. The round difference is like really huge right there. We're taking a look at the groups with still some things not updated right here. These are fresh groups as we walked into them today as it started. But from that point on, Legends won and lost a match already. They've already got 4 matches played with 9 points. They still stand at the top of the group, but Tricked is trying to catch up to them with 2 matches played. They have 2 victories, so that is definitely huge for them. I'm not sure how Isaba did, actually, though, and that's definitely also interesting. So there we are, and the groups and the schedule for today, all the matches that we do get to see right here. And right now we'll be tuning into Vexed versus Euronics. Right after that one, we're gonna get to see Playing Ducks versus Vexed. So yeah, we are definitely kind of following Vexed today right here, and I'm surely fired up about that. Though Rank S are becoming kind of that more a team to look at rather than Vexed in the French teams that are taking part in the competition. So I know Vex really have to prove us that they're still good right here, because if they lose this matchup, they're falling very far behind.
Yeah, so pressure on them. We're gonna, as you said, take a look at them for 2 matches in a row now. It's going to be, hopefully, going to be a nice end to the evening. And we're going straight into the game. No more waiting.
Yeah.
Because the knife round is coming up.
So yeah, that's true. We're gonna get in there, and the map is a Mirage. Not even the knife round, but the pistol round in here is already Nexa. The stand-in that's hopping in right here is going in, and that's gonna be Euronics Gaming not being able to actually break through the defenses of Vexed Gaming. 3-4 kills for the CTs. All over the way, it's gonna be Vexed Gaming taking this pistol round most probably, unless Belzer can do something still in here. He's got the double kill this far. If he's really looking for the ace, well, he's got to make it quick because he's just getting surrounded and collapsed on top of by Vexed Gaming. So 1-0 right here in favor of the French team.
Yes. So there we go. Vexed Gaming on Mirage. I haven't really seen Euronics on Mirage. I don't know what to expect from them. But Vexed, this is a map that should be in their favor. And a good start as well. This is looking good for them. But now, will they be able to stand 5 deagles? Well, Euronics, that's interesting. I mean, you usually see Tech9's fast plays, but 5 deagles just spreading out, looking for picks that hasn't been found yet.
Well, yeah, Fails are playing without it. Kevlar is the only player on his team, and he's already down to 18 HP. Then Skrunk receives an HE that delivers 51 points of damage to him. He's also pretty low now. So Euronics definitely have to be really careful in here, or 2 deaths might be on their, might be happening on their side real shortly. I don't know, that's not going to be bringing him any more success out there, but finally hits that shot with the scout and might be expecting some more people here in the connector, as the terrorists are indeed just jumping in. Skrunk and David K out there specifically.
Yeah, Runebang is holding very close. And exactly what David is going to just come spray him down. Another guy is expected in connector.
Ooh, wow.
Okay.
Good Sikin position. There.
Yeah, good position. They did not expect that. But Sikin, on the other hand, did not expect another guy to be on shore. So that's an easy kill for Jared. The last guy has been spotted. Skrunk is being hunted down in underground. And pretty clean round for Vex. You have to say they only lost Smiley.
Yeah, so Vexed Gaming, actually not a bad beginning definitely to this map, and that's something good for these guys. Every tiniest bit of motivation that they can get is very important. With 0-2 scoreline, they must not really be too happy about what it looks like right now. So Surely these two rounds, possibly another one, probably, I wanted to say. But you never know. Yesterday we had so many ecos won, actually, that could just as well happen in here very shortly. Nexa, though, once again leading the charge for Euronics Gaming. Well, they are trying to use him as much as possible, but Smiley once again shutting not only him down, but also gets the kill and fails up. Finally, Psyker replies with the bomb planted. It's actually a good round this far by Euronics Gaming, after all being just a pure eco. And take a look at that. Another kill comes through. They can pick up the weapons, but actually, that scout's not going to be too useful in the situation. MPK to finish off the last man on Euronics Gaming. 3-0 is the scoreline.
And, I mean, we have to give it. It was a good eco, only having Glocks. They got the bomb plant, which definitely benefits their economy. There will be an AWP being purchased, I assume. Failsar definitely has the money. And yes, there it comes in. Vexed Gaming has also been able to store quite a lot of money, but still, they're sticking to 2 UMPs, which is a very, very interesting decision. A lot of utility there. The early mid control there is trying to be claimed by Failsar,
who he now was close. He was blinded by the flashbangs, but there was definitely a chance to get a kill.
Yeah, Failsar's forcing them away. We have MPK smoked out in window here, but it's not going to be that easy. You can just play against Failsar. As long as they don't peek, as they don't give him any info or picks, they'll eventually have to make a move from mid to either fall back or to try to claim connector or short, which will be interesting to see. MPK getting re-smoked there, so he's stuck in the corner. He's not moving. He has all time. Meanwhile, Nexa finding Jared. And here we go, the Terrans are moving up in connector, trying to claim more and more map control. Nexa lurking in palace. This is very interesting and it looks good. But the bomb hasn't been picked up, so we don't know what to expect.
Nice idea of throwing in that flashbang from Vex, but that flashbang didn't blind the terrorist at all. Still a great shot from Anomet. Now he's going to go down to Failsar, though, unfortunately for himself. And Vexa Gaming seems like right off the bat as he runs his cap. The fall bite might be a chance to lose a round, but there goes Skrunk. Actually down to Smiley. Smiley previously with a double kill on that bomb site. Him getting a double kill this round would be extremely crucial to Vex still turning around that pretty tough situation. And just take a look at the HP. David K is down to 5. Failsar and Psyker also aren't like completely healthy. You know, Failsar though, picking off Smiley is going to make these chances really, really slim. For Roombank, who's still sitting on Tetris, so that's a good position for him. The enemy's not expecting him out there possibly at all. But having checked out bombsite B slightly, having positioned themselves in the CT spawn and in the jungle connector, they know that he's got to be coming from that kind of side of the map, so still pretty easy assumption made. And David K, the guy that had very low HP, manages to close it out all by himself.
Here we go, a replay from the previous round, of course, where Nexa gets a refrag there up in palace, which was good. Sort of denied them the A split possibilities there. Anyway, on to a new round. Jared trying to shoot them through the smoke. Actually goes down in underground. This is very interesting. What is okay, from underground goes back to connector. Now it's returning to jungle. Okay, a little strange path there to take, but he's still alive. So no worries. The double AWP setup for Vexed is working out good so far. It's granting them one entry frag. Euronics once again looking to claim the mid control. It worked out good the last time, but with two AWPs, this decision can get problematic if they lose any more early frags.
Well, Failsar actually gets one in return. Back to 4-on-4, and NPK gets spotted out real quickly. Next already has a molly prepared. He wants to bring him down as quickly as possible, but Roombang does waste this opportunity a little bit. However, with the amount of enemies waiting at the connector, I don't think that's wasted as him staying alive in there. 2-for-2, it still continues with a very evened out situation. Smiley and Alumen now together, they will try to reclaim that site. Not like last round, where Smiley was picked off because he was alone. And Roombang was waiting on the Tetris. The bomb's not yet planted. It's not yet even on the back of the terrorist team. Oh, that's going to be a little bit of team damage delivery, if I'm not mistaken, right there. Or that was Smiley just receiving the damage from David K. Does not matter, though. It is Vex Gaming getting slightly mixed up out there, and bomb is planted. That's the play, the space Euronix needed, and is given straight into the hands by Vex Gaming themselves. Alumetz switches out the weapon, does not want to fight with the AWP anymore. He just knows he's got to get into close quarters with the remaining guys. But as he realizes, that's also going to be hard. He just picks up the AWP back again and falls back from that bombsite overall, just saving up the weapon.
Yeah, so that is another... Ooh, the pass has been called. That was, either way, another game for... another round for Euronix Gaming, and the mid control thing that they always get going in the beginning is working out very, very well, even though that they lost the first guy to one of the orbs this time. They made it work anyway, just slowly but steadily working up, getting connector control. And now we see, was it Pulse coming in? Is that?
Yeah, Saiken just disconnected from the server, so apparently he'll be coming back in a second. Yeah there he
that
is.
That's quick. That's great. We want no more long pauses you've had.
Nah, well,
you felt quite a bit of those. But yeah, we're moving on pretty quickly. Just gonna... Okay. It's been unpaused. That's a quick one. Feels good to be moving back into the game. We see Euronix expecting Vex to be on a full eco, which they are on. Everybody except Alamet, who was able to save that AWP. Two MAC-10s being invested in, so these guys are looking to farm, they're looking to do something quick. And a B-Rush with only poor little Smiley holding it off by himself. This is gonna be terrible for him. There we go. MAC-10s used perfectly.
Yeah, that also, well, him being there alone also is not gonna be a lot of money for Euronix. They're not gonna be able to use these MACs too well, other than just getting that single kill. But also Alamet peeking in from shore, he doesn't hit his shot, that's pretty bad. And he's gonna get run down. AWP down on the ground. Next save and finds that other kill. Rubik was supposed to surprise, reclaim that weapon. A second after, though, that did not happen. It is $1,200 going straight into the pockets of Nexa. Plus, he picks up that AWP. That's immeasurable gains for him throughout this round. And NPK all alone, he was waiting for Nexa to peek right after. He was also willing to finish him off, but that Nexa did not fall for. Also, he's just looking through everything prepared by Vex Gaming in this round. And 6 HP only remaining after the bomb's explosion for David Case. Tyken had only 2 points of health on his account. Also stays alive. Euronix feeling quite fine after this round. And here's the reply of Nexa's amazing situation here. Looks right straight off the bat. Does not care about that AWP too much, and a lot of players would actually just jump on top of the AWP, pick it up without even thinking what could be waiting around the next corner.
Fails with one of the, actually a double AWP now. Next, as we saw, picked it up in the previous round, and fails, decided to invest in one of his own. So that's interesting. That's not what a lot of teams do, on the terrorist side at least. But getting one entry, it's indeed a good start. They are, as always, slowly working to claim mid control. They're not getting any more resistance there in mid, so should be able to slowly, steadily take full control and then work for an 8-split, as it seems. Ooh. Ooh, look, Alamet with a scout. Surprise, surprise, Fails does no longer have an AWP. But here we go, slightly delayed, the 8-split is still coming in. That Molotov is not very well timed. These guys are still running up through connector, finding another frag onto Alamet. So, bomb's going down.
No, not good. That's going to be actually the bomb planted. Rumbang gets that kill a little bit late, and he's got one man right above his head. That's going to be really tricky. David K next to him in the jungle is NPK. Oh, the players are so close to each other, nearly hiding each other. But he's going to be Vex Gaming with the upper hand, of course, as well. The post-plan positions are quite obvious. That's also a leg shot. Not enough. Nexa gets a double. And the CTs are not able to defuse it anymore. Smiley's going to have some problems. He hides behind the first box. And he once again goes back to the bomb. And he decides to run away. He's lost the round. Amazing of a play from Nexa. And the previous round, it was just for fun. He was playing with a MAC-10. They would have the round in their hands anyway. But this time, that's an amazing clutch.
And with not having the defuse kit, being forced back, that is just That really hurts to see.
3v1 they had right there, and Nexa was expecting one man to be underneath the wood just after that kill on the planter. He just had to know.
Yeah, they had the info, but no utility. They could just have smoked him off, or a Molotov while they were defusing. But they couldn't even do that, so insane plays by Nexa. And they're now in the lead, Euronix 4-3 in the lead, looking to pick up their fifth round, as well as Vexto having a very poor buy. Only Smiley with the AK that he managed to save. He is still alive, but as his teammates are dying, saving this AK and this Kevlar another round could be an option. He is though B, and as the terrorist, oh wait! Wow, that's one, that's two! Look at this, Skrunk is left, he's spotted Skrunk, but he's not gonna get the third, that would have been insane. Roombang now with Sicken on 2 HP, this is doable, but being nowhere near without Kevlar, without Diffuse Kid. Is he going back to go for exit? It's a very tough decision to take.
Probably is going to risk it to at least get a little bit more gains out of this round. But this round's definitely landing on the hands of Euronix. But great play from Smiley. Roombang also being able to get that one kill always makes it a lot tougher on Euronix Gaming. They will have to be a little bit afraid. They're not like getting free rounds in here. And they're not like grabbing a lot of money for themselves, because their bank is not going to be so full. Nobody with more than 10,000 just yet. So it's just a matter of losing one round. And we're losing a lot of weapons on another, and they're gonna have to eco real quick. But Vex Gaming, first of all, they have to put their hands on the victorious rounds, which is not something that we're seeing in here. The pistol round is giving them the three that they have on their account. Other than that,
yeah, five rounds in a row for Euronix. It's very good for the Tyrant side. They're really making this work. Vex feel like the way to counter Euronix. Euronix winning spree here is to invest in a double orb setup, like Euronix had done several times, to challenge them for the mid control, which they pretty much gain for free every round. So here we go, Alamat is the first guy to challenge. Mm-hmm. The two orbs has already found two frags, one refrag there by Sykin, but they still have, look, the force back from mid. So now they have secured mid control of their own. They also have the man advantage.
That's a great shot from Jared. And in the meantime, Nexa also tried to take a little bit of control of bombsite A, thinking that maybe they rotated over the middle or B, but that was not the case. He got killed off on Tetris. Now Sykin, the second, and still he's the only guy that frags this round for Euronix Gaming. Sees another man, does not manage to take that one home. And he knows that Jared should be around the inside of the bombsite. Has he got the kill a little bit earlier, but he missed the first shot, and Sykin just wants to speed it up a little bit. Of course, a good decision against an AWPer, but Jared just had the superior position.
Indeed, that was the case. So Vex getting closer and closer to tying the score, and that's something they have to do. Euronix taking control of this game, already up on five rounds on the terrorist line. We have to keep in mind that this is a CG side of map, and they can't allow Euronix to get too many more rounds. They have to just shut them down and continuing reinvesting in a new orb. So double orb setup is apparently their way of approaching this, and it worked out the previous round. Let's see how well they do against a fast A split. Fails is currently pushed out of sight, but three guys are approaching on ramp. David is already on the site looking. Was that through the smoke? I'm not sure. Jared got an important kill anyhow. Still 4v4. The bomb has to go down before the smoke fades, preferably they still have a lot of time. And here we go. No. So the smokes are still up, but
close, but No cigar right here for Alamet. He was taking his chances, but did not have like 100% good of an idea of where the bomb was being planted. Now, that is one man lead in favor of Euronix. Now, the bomb is already ticking with, once again, not very much utility, as you mentioned, for Vex Gaming. They have two smokes remaining and a flashbang, and then PK is going to be the only one that gets some kills out of this one, leaving Smiley alone. And with that, there is no possibility for Vex to win the round anymore. And now the question is, will Smiley even stay alive? He's still got that AK from a couple of rounds ago and holds on to it, luckily enough, as David K is not enough to win against him. There was another guy getting into the jungle, but he decided to fall back and leave it all up to David. Which, wasn't the greatest idea, turns out. Still, at the end of the day, Euronix will be extremely happy that they won the round. They just reset Vex's economy.
Exactly. I mean, that is huge. They got the three first round, of course. Euronix then picking up five rounds in a row after the first buy round, allowing Vex, or not allowing, but Vex picked up one, but it failed now to pick up the 10th round, so with them being completely reset, they're going for a force, which is surprisingly good.
Yeah, that's very surprising, as you say. Definitely weren't expecting to have the rifles on the hands of Vex Gaming, but that's once again comes back to them picking up a lot of rifles, kind of saving a couple times, and as I mentioned, it's Euronics who's not supposed to have some good economy. Vex Gaming are not so bad on it. That aspect of the game this far, 1-for-1, though Failsor is down to 8 HP already, and Aluminum's gonna hit another hit shot with the scout. This guy's just amazing with the SSG-08. But Skrunk's trying to surprise him, and he will surprise. Aluminum's not looking that way, although still a tough angle. Gets the shot down. Skrunk's down to 28, and Aluminum down to 30. Still comes out on top of this fight, even if by just a tiny bit.
Yeah, that was huge. We see now with Skrunk being tagged down by Aluminum and Fails already being on 8 HP. This is tough. This is really tough. Rooming in a great position. He's going to take... Okay, David and Fails, they just made this possible. Okay,
yeah.
Despite being on low HP, David, the guy who has 76 HP, is still alive. Get picking up the 3-kick there. He's going huge for his team.
Again!
Aluminum, look, Aluminum has tagged both of the players that are alive, and he has to tag them one more time. Now, actually picked up a rifle, which makes things easier for him. Gets the triple, looking for the quad. With the info, he's defining quickly now. He has a defuse kit. David is hiding, waiting, holding the close corner now. That flash is not going to affect him. David picks up, still Aluminum gets the frag. Quad kill there by him. What is this guy doing?
Getting the AWP for himself, defusing the bomb apparently. A quad kill in such a situation. He was down to 30 HP. But as you said, he just tagged both of the remaining terrorists down to 8. And it was just a matter of hitting one single shot on both the sides. But they didn't even manage to skate him at the end. Aluminum right now, he's of course the highlight of the game this far. 13 kills, 7 hit shots.
Yeah, but the funny thing is that most of the headshots are with a scout.
Yeah, that's true. That's just also another great thing about him. Playing with the AWP right now himself. Earlier on, it would be Jared or Alamet. Now, he's the sole offer right here, but he did let one guy get through. Now, that could be a little bit surprising, and that's a little bit of a wasted opportunity. Vex really needs Alamet performing if they are to win some rounds. Now, the deagle, though, doesn't work out. Right here on the T-slope, Jared finding a kill for himself too. Finally, there's a refrag from Euronics, and this match, this round, but also definitely this match, is on the knife edge right here. A little bit less HP for MPK. The bomb's getting planted on bombsite B, and Euronics, they need to find some good afterplay positions. What a shot from Skrunk! He expected Roombank to be somewhere out there somehow. It's not such a common position.
A Skrunk picking up, first getting the kill, completely surprising. Alameda is going a little bit too aggressive, picks up his orb, gets 2 kills after that. And it seems like those amazing players have secured the round, because Vex Gaming, they are not really thinking about entering the site anymore. They're just holding for some possible exit frags, which they are also not going to get, as the Terrors are leaving the site in a gathered squad.
Yeah, so also, once again, we're going to get to see Vex Gaming saving up a couple of weapons. Once again, possibly that equipment's not going to be so bad for them, with Smiley saving up the grenades, with MPK saving up the fuse kit. So always there is the tiny bit of utility for them that you were talking about all the time, but, well, I don't think that utility is the only thing they lack right here. That's
no,
the thing.
There's definitely several other things, but... Now they actually have quite the utility. Aluminum, we're not going to count them out, even though they are not as well as equipped as Euronics are. Yeah. Aluminum, still, we've seen what this guy's capable of with the scout, and getting tagged down early. No entries yet, which is looking good. The Terrors has already claimed mid control, getting up in connector here. Where is Aluminum holding?
Well, that's the question. Previously, he would show up sometimes here in the jungle, sometimes on the tickets booth. Now he's on the jungle and he just gets spotted out by Tyken way too quickly to be able to act at all. But MPK replies with a kill of his own. It's not so bad. I mean, Aluminum did not deal the damage directly himself, but allows his teammates to find out a little bit more about Euronics' positions. And there's the Molly flying in and rune back on the ninja spot. That's going to be a very good one. The Mollies are everywhere but there. So that might give them the info that somebody is actually sitting in there. But it's just such a rare position. They don't check it. Nexa, though, at the right moment, peeks into the side to check if everything is actually all right. And, well, it wasn't. But now he corrected it. And Skrunk has to die. But leaving NPK all alone in a 1v3, it's going to be pretty complicated. But he makes it a 1v2 right off the bat. But fails there. He's perfectly prepared with the AWP in the same position Alumet was in just like 30 seconds ago.
Yes. These guys are just continuing, despite Vex having some pretty good individual performances from time to time. You're honest, they're just playing, they're a machine right now. They really, everything they do with the mid control, they're not stressing, they're not going too fast, they're not going too slow. They know exactly what they're doing. Here they go, challenging for the mid control, and with Vex being only on pistols, a full leak of this should be a lot easier.
What? Spades are actually missing so many shots right there. This might be a little bit disgraceful, but luckily enough for himself, he's got Saiken right at his side. And yeah, Saiken with a double. Now, the simple pistols and Vex Gaming are not going to impress us too much, I guess. But with Runeback now finding two kills, it gets a little bit better for them. But it's just so close to the ending of the first half. And if they don't get any weapon out of it that they're able to save, these kills still don't mean anything. Euronics will have the money for themselves, that's sure.
Yeah, look at David. He says, nope, you know, ain't gonna get any guns. He's throwing them out of the map. And it is just really, really tough for Smiley. Don't know how much money these guys actually have, but Smiley being on 1,700, the losing bonus not being too big since they won around not just a few rounds ago. Their buy might not be the best. David is hunting, hunting the body set, hunting the remains to ensure Smiley not being able to pick up a gun.
Well,
Smiley walking towards mid. I mean, he probably wanted to loot these dead bodies, but nope. It's not going to be anything.
Yeah, you revealed himself right at the end right there, but nobody's really following him too much. And that's, I think, a good decision from Euronics Gaming. They might not know about it, but there's no Kevlar on Smiley, so only saving up that 5-7 isn't really anything for him. And the most important thing is just not giving them a rifle one. That's exactly what's happening. Euronics keeping them all for themselves.
That is true. So once again, watching, I wondered if Alamo was going to go for the scout and the utility, but now he goes for an M4. And look, these guys are lacking utility again. Sometimes when they are performing good in the early stages of a...
And Saiken just shows fails are how you shoot with the AWP, apparently.
Yeah, fails are. He's sort of... Okay, feels like got it back.
Yeah.
Okay, that's great. Seiko's just going to show, you know, how it's done. Gave him an early frag, but as I said before, sometimes even when Vex does good in the early stages of the round, you see, the utility, no smokes, no molotovs, no kit. In the afterplants, when they get afterplants, they are suffering because they have no utility, they have nothing to work with, which means that they often lose the round anyway.
Yeah, that's the huge problem that Vex Gaming are facing in here, and 10-5 is surely a possibility for Euronics Gaming. Then they will get transferred over to the CT side. Pistol round once again is going to decide a lot. We saw a similar situation yesterday where Playing Ducks were able to turn it all around and get the map for themselves. The Euronics, they actually had the experience against Playing Ducks, so they know better than that for sure. Now, 4-on-2 in their favor, and this round is just collapsing completely for Vex, especially as Jared even gets caught out still in the middle by David K. That's a little bit surprising for sure. And with the bomb planted, as you said, there's the upper plant position with just a single flashbang, and he's getting surrounded completely. The bomb was also on B while he was going for the shoot down against the guy on A, knowing nothing about the situation on the map.
So there we go, the first half ends 10-5 in favor of Euronics Gaming on the terrorist side.
Yeah.
We don't have to point out that this is a quite CT-sided map, and this was not good for Vexed. Coming into this tournament, we expected this guy to do a lot more. I mean, they are in the ECA Premier. They are one of the top tier teams in this tournament. And so far, they haven't showed us anything.
Definitely a huge name also, talking about Vexed Gaming. When they still had the Polish team, these guys have been achieving some good stuff. And they were on the second place in Poland. The nowadays Team Kinguin weren't doing so well back there. And every single time they met each other, it was actually Vexed, like, a little bit better. Now Vexed Gaming picked up that Platinum lineup, they replaced a couple of players, and it turns out that Rank S are actually able to beat the Vexed, so maybe replacing these guys was not the greatest idea after all.
Yeah, that's possible. Regretting their decisions afterwards. But now we are getting directly into the second pistol round here, and Vexed, they would really need to pick this one up.
Yeah.
So a lot on stake. Euronics not doing anything too crazy, but having one guy keeping control of the B apps allows him to stack A pretty much. Great entries there by the USPS. He's holding surprisingly close, though. Jared's going to find one. Jared looking for Saiken as well. He's not going to get him. Saiken, are you kidding me? Pushes out with 3 kills now. Just holding the A-side by himself. Easy peasy. Skrunk finishes it off. And this was not good for Vexed.
And yeah, we pointed out how well Alamek can play with that scout, but then you just take a look at Saiken. When fails are fails, he just backs him up with the AK, being able to get a couple of headshots out there. Then he takes over the AWP, gets the kills with the AWP. Then in the pistol round, he obliterates the entirety of Vexed Gaming nearly all by himself. And he's just such an all-rounder right here. And well, Alamek once again has the scout, but yeah, he's gotta have the scout to actually perform, it feels like, at this point. The one-man lead is picked up by Vexed Gaming. That could be a little bit of a surprise right here that we're looking forwards to, definitely. That could save Vexed Gaming in the matchup. But just as I say that, Nexa evens the things out, killing NPK with a UMP of his. And it's UMPs versus pistols, so actually not even a single rifle available for Euronics for now.
Still, Alamat with a with a scout, trying to do some things. Jared's coming in. Oh, Alamat has to find the reefer, but with a scout, that's not the easiest thing to do. Actually, tags him. David just running back. Ooh, look at this. Grunt gets completely caught off guard with a knife in his hand. Nexus coming back, looking to avenge his teammate. Will not even find Spike. Look at this. And meanwhile, the battling connector's going down. Alamut actually finds David up in ladder room.
It's amazing. Smiley with 4 HP remaining out there. I actually thought Smiley was already dead. But still was looking at the red HP on the last man standing on Euronics. It looked really bad. I didn't think he could win the fight against Alamed, and he didn't even get there. Smiley survived. Smiley got him down and got the round for Vexed, which is the most important thing right now for them. That saves them, that keeps them alive. The Terrorist team can still battle it out. And Nexa now picks up the scout, but comparing himself to Alamed is not going to be an easy task. Alamet actually in the B apartments. He's looking to deliver some damage out there.
Yes, nobody's peeking there, so Alamet's gonna be forced back. So far, no damage has been dealt to anybody except Skrung, who's down 29 HP. 29 HP, could that be your scout tag? Not sure if Alamet found him there, but he is either way on pretty low HP, which doesn't favor his team, especially not since they are only on pistols.
Definitely is a possibility that he was hit right there as covering bomb site B. Alamet was in the B apartment, is probably the only guy from Vex Gaming. That adds up, but now Nexa. Well, that's the scout versus scout. Actually, none of them hitting their targets again. And no damage delivered. Nexa still struggling. Now he finally gets tagged down to 12 HP, and now too bad of a situation for him. And Alamet cannot kill with the scout if it's not a headshot, apparently.
Exactly. I was actually thinking that. Always in the head. I mean, it's good to practice, you know, get them in the head. So when they're full HP, they die anyway.
But back to 2-on-2 all of a sudden. So it was a great beginning to the round from Vexed, but it's not remaining as such. Saiken's picked up the M4, and you know how dangerous Saiken can be. No tag down this time from the scout, and it's 100% versus 78. But Saiken's just waiting with the Deagle, wants to get the headshot. And of course, he's got no defuse kit, so he just waited. So desperate for the enemy to peek at him.
No one actually had a good opportunity. It's other problem, you know, Euronics, now it was their turn not to have any utility. And it's so hard. When they have a guy in Palace, when you're alone, you have nothing to force him out with. Just great afterplan play, which secured them another round. So this could allow them to catch up. They're obviously not going to tie the score in the upcoming rounds, but building up their economy now, just giving themselves the opportunity at least, is a good start to the second half.
Yeah, well, NPK now the only guy with the SMG still, while Euronics pure pistols, no Kevlars, if we're talking about that utility, no grenades, no defuse kits at all, and it's hard to imagine if there even is a chance for him to get close to this bomb in the first place in this round. The bomb is indeed being planted on bomb site A. That was taken very easily by Vex. There was nobody in here from Uronix, and now stacking up that bomb site B definitely has not paid out for them. Nexo is also going to get run down right here by MPK, but then Strunk has a chance of keys, gets the ding, 2 HP, and then PK doesn't grind it out. Element stole away the frag, but also possibly saved his life right there.
Yes, and being able to save all these fire rifles definitely benefits their economy. Uronix are, though, of course, going. They're going to try to shut it down to break Vex's little piggy bank that is quite stuffed at the moment. So 8 to 11. It's still, even though Vex has done a very good start to this, they still have to pick up this round. It's a very crucial round, because if they don't, Uronix still continue to get closer and closer to 16. Here we go. It's a quick B play coming in. Skrunk's already found one. That's a great flashbang. Trying to keep them off. Wow. Oh, the peak Skrunk! Oh my god, Skrunk gets some really important kills. Fails is helping him from kitchen, and after getting two frags, actually goes into the side. This guy, there's no stop to this guy.
Gets surprised completely as NPK was up close. NPK gets another one in there, actually, at the same time, and only Tycon remains, but Tycon, he's just so close, and they don't see him!
What?
That was such a great kill from Tycon! Great position gained by him really quickly, but Smiley still able to keep him down at the end of this round. Amazing of a situation. 11-9 in favor of Uronix Gaming. That advantage that they've been building up for so long is melting now.
Yes, it is, and so is their economy. They forced into another eco. Two guys having Kevlars, but this is not going to be a problem for Vex Gaming as they're approaching the B side fully equipped. And if they win this round, it's just going to be a one round difference. It's looking very good for them, also building up their economy. One kill, but David with a deal. Are you kidding me? Two kills when he has to reload. He can't get any more, but that's amazing. The early advantage. Oh, fails are as well on the site. Able to stack B with three people, getting kills and intel from behind. As Roombang is focused on fails out, what happened?
That's Uronix Gaming actually breaking through at the most important moment when Vex Gaming started to recover, when they started to gain control over what is happening in the game. That control completely slips. They're broken out of this trance, and Uronix are back in the lead, I would like to say, but not so sure about that just yet. Still a force buy from Vex Gaming. They still had a little bit of money remaining out there. It's going to be an AWP, 3 AKs, one man, still with a Kevlar and helmet, but only with a Tech 9 out there. Additionally, some grenades on his hands. But Uronix Gaming, if they win this round, they're already getting so close to winning the entire best of one series. So that's just such a crucial round to both the teams. This matters the most.
Indeed it is. Nearly good. Another fast beat. Skrunk goes down immediately. We see his fails are around.
And Jared from behind, he's going to close in from Catwalk. That is a major kill from him. But fails are actually indeed with that AWP. Tries to help out his team as much as possible. Jared, he's still not spotted out there. Oh, they gave him so much time, but he still goes down. Phaser took a peek at the last moment. Roomback still, though, gets in. And that makes it a 3v1. Hard to imagine Nyx is still winning it. Good positions assumed by the terrorist team, especially as another guy manages to make it through the window. And Alamet, at the end of the day, hits the shot with the AWP up here. So Vex Gaming are back. They recovered, and that's very important. When you lose a round like this, when you lose an eco or a force buy, then you have to just erase it from your mind, from your thoughts, and just force buy like they did, and get back into it.
We see this is interesting because Jared is getting a MAC-10. You know, he's looking to farm here, but little does he expect Uronix with actually having three guys above 4,000. They're going to go for the force. They're doing it. They did it with Deagles the last time. Why can't they do it with two orbs, an M4, and two pistols? This is still very doable. I like that they actually used the money to get double orb. Oh. Glass cannon on both, actually.
Yeah, that's the thing. They only have Kevlar on David K and Skrunk, and that's a bad situation for Psyker, not being able to get that kill. He just looked the death into the eyes and faced it. Alamet was better on that battle and on many others this far, definitely.
Yeah.
Great sniper that Vex Gaming have right there. But sometimes it feels like he's the only one. And that's the thing that they have to change if they really want to win this map.
Yes, if Vincent was here, we would have called Euronix a German, well-oiled machine, while Vexed is relying on some of their top-performing players. And even if Alamedo, as he is, performing very good, they are still struggling to beat Euronix. So he'll definitely need some help. He needs company on top of the scoreboard. That's what I think, at least. The game is... the round is going on with 30 seconds left, actually. These guys will have to hurry up. Going very, very slow. Nexa is in a good position with his AWP. Still one left. The other AWP has been picked up by Fatal, so we know what he's capable of doing with that as well. Nexa's when he's getting smoked off. But 3v4, 16 seconds, 15 now. They have to get on towards the site, and they are being watched. MK goes for the plant. Fatal tries to wallbang, but it's so close. Bomb is going to go down. Skrong is really close, though. Meanwhile, gets himself into great position. Smiley is behind the books. They know exactly where he is. Runebang is 6 HP in Palace. This retake, it must happen. Nexa, he knows. Oh, jumps up on the books, gets the frag. And low HP Runebang will also get taken down. Euronix on that force. It was the right thing to do. With two pistols, Kevlar's. No worries. They took the round anyway. And now we're going to take a look at some replays.
Yeah, that's going to be Nexa jumping on top of that box. Huge kill for him. Definitely making a mistake right there. Might have still won Vex Gaming the round. But Smiley was just so surrounded. He had no idea what was happening right there. He just counted on a little bit of support from the Palace. But the guy being so low on health also didn't really favor them. And still, the bomb plant did happen. So Vex Gaming still have a little bit of money right there, and they're gonna try to take it back, claw it back for themselves. So Euronix getting dangerously close to winning the entire map. Alamed is not gonna have to actually kill off Nexus. NPK joins in the fray. One man lead for them. This time the bomb plant happens a lot earlier and in a lot better of a situation for them. They have the map control. They have Smiley up here close. Alamed kills off Skrunk. Failzo was not supposed to even take a peek up so close. He thought that Skrunk was gonna take care of that guy. And when he started shooting, he ended up dying. Alamed again with a double kill. Crucial double kill.
I would love to have a player highlight soon. Just take a look at the scoreboard to see how well Alamed actually is performing, because round after round, look at this, on top of the scoreboard, 22-17. He is actually accompanied by Smiley, who's been starting to perform better and better now when Vexed are trying to come back into this game, but really, really, really well done every time. Okay, so now it's Euronix's turn. They're actually going for the force. This is the third force buy in a round. So they are going to try to win it back. They did it last time, but can they do it now? They are not as well equipped. Last time they had two AWPs and an M4. Now they're stuck with two UMPs, three pistols, and with Alamat finding another crucial entry, this can be tough.
Now, AWP was very important for them back there. Being able to get two kills while retaking the site, 2 out of 3 kills with the AWP, and definitely pretty big. Now, with one man down, and Alamat once again is the guy that is bringing Euronix down. It's gonna be really tough, more than tough right now. The deagles, they have to make them work again. There has to be another double kill for David K or something if they really want to turn it all around.
Yeah, David was in this position. Okay, some MBK lurking. He actually gets the frag. That's unfortunate, because now we see the rotation. We see Skrunk rotating a little towards A, or being unsure. You see MPK, perfect fake, and the CTs, they are buying it. Everybody now over towards A, while the B side, it's free to take. And, if David would have stayed, got all the two kills with the Deagle as he got the previous force round, things could have worked out better, but completely tricked. There's nothing they can do but save.
That's true, and, Euronix Gaming forcing up, then... It worked out so many times. They definitely were counting on it again. This time, the UMPs weren't enough. The Deagles weren't enough. Even saving up these UMPs doesn't really give them so much after all. They have the Kevlars and helmets, which is the most important thing right there, I'd assume. And also one single defuse kit. That flashbang, it's going to be a bit of something. But a bitter taste will remain. And Vexed are getting nearly the equalizer, I'd like to say. I don't think that Euronics will be able to fight for the next round either. They're going to have the pretty much same situation. But then maybe Alamut will not get an entry kill or something and they'll have a little bit more of a chance. Still, though, they don't upgrade at all. They're going to be missing some Kevlars even right here on Failzone, so I can...
Yes, they've gone for some pretty crazy forces, but now when they actually can have a full buy and the score will only be 13-13, that's definitely not something you want to waste with a reckless force buy. But they still, as you mentioned, have a fair chance of picking this one up. We've seen them do this with a similar buy. Two SMGs is good, and interesting setup here with the guys in Connector. Vex have pretty frequently gone for the mid connector control, and this, as it is an A-split, two guys will actually move up towards connector where the CTs are waiting. Saiken, what are you doing? Turning his back.
Jared just barely sees the top of Phaser's head. Phaser is able to get the kill on Smiley with 4. Saiken is going to get another one, and the AK lands straight into his hands, and they know that there's no more people in the middle. That's just getting so good. Another headshot, this time from Strong, this time a little bit different of a weapon, but he's able to get even another. He gets bugged on the ladder trying to run away from there, and that gives him a kill on Roombang. This is just such a stroke of luck for Euronics, and I did not believe it. I did not believe that they could take this round, but they surprise again.
Here we go. Alamut.
He might be the top player of the game this far, yes. But Euronics, definitely they're ahead.
Yeah. It doesn't matter, because Euronics, this round was a little bit lucky, as you mentioned. The ace that happened when they had full control connector. They got the guns, they picked them up, and winning that round is just... It hurts to watch Vexed Gaming, who has been working really, really well on this comeback so far. They got shut down. Luckily, they still have some money after picking up several rounds in a row, so it's going to be another full buy for both of the teams. Smiley starting off early with an entry, and Vexed going for mid control, as pretty much always. Bomb is left behind, so they're not looking to do anything fast here. They're just chilling with more than 1 minute left on the clock. The bomb will get picked up and it will be brought towards A, as it seems. We have Jared, who is chilling in connector. They're not putting two guys in connector. They don't want to risk what happened last round. He's going to be the only guy entering from connector while his teammates are setting up smokes for the A execute that's coming in.
Yeah, but there's nobody from Euronics like in the previous round. Focused on that middle, focused on the connector so much, and Nexus gonna get that kill way too easily. My goodness, it's falling apart for them. Fails now with the AWP. If he doesn't whiff, that's already such a huge advantage. Nexa is going to get another kill, but then they finally get in from the ramps, and that distracts Fails a little bit, so he doesn't spot out the guy peeking in from the palace, but he also doesn't manage to get the kill. It was not Alamut with the AWP, it was just the AK dealing 25 points of damage.
Look
to Fails.
Look at this. Rooming is planting Fails. He's allowing it to. He doesn't go for the full peek there, which is unfortunate. It will allow Vex to get the bomb. Now Fails still gets a kill. That's very good. Now they have some utility as well. Fails has a Molotov, which he can use to force out the guy either in ramp or in palace. He can stick it, but he doesn't.
Oh, man.
That Molotov is good. Molotov really good. They don't know what MBK is. He's coming from ramp. And Saiken is going to spot him when he comes in the full
BQ. They don't even need to. Yeah, no. That was a new defused MBK. Decided to resign. And staying in the palace, and I don't think it was a good idea. I mean, probably they did not also know that there's going to be someone on the ramp that they're going to force out with the Molly.
No.
But yeah, that Molly destroyed the plan for Vex Gaming completely.
And it also destroyed, not completely destroyed, but it really gave their economy a little time. We see Jared, does he actually have a gun? Is he running around with a Glock there? Okay, there he is, naked. But Roombang is with a Deagle only, so they are suffering a little bit there. Still has a lot of utility, so it doesn't matter what they have. They just have to win this round, or they are pretty much out of this competition, because they haven't done good before. This is a very important match for them.
Okay, one for one. That's an AWP showdown right there in the middle. Although the AWP is already missing for Euronics, after getting the kill, Phaser goes down himself. Roombang. With that Deagle, he's now got some weapon to be picked up out there in the mid, too. So that will be rifles versus rifles. It's going to be a fair and square round.
It is indeed, but is not always an advantage to get the AWP, to get to keep the AWP on the tower side, because if they're going for an execute, if they get pressured, it's not really fun to enter a site with an AWP when things have to go quickly. Look at this, David in a great position. He's going to find Runebanger. This Mikoto thing is not working out too good. Alma with the second refrag. Okay, at least he's cleaning up for his teammates. He's doing a good job. One guy going in alone here towards B. It's going to be Smiley. His teammates are quite far behind him. Actually, one guy on short as well. We'll see Skrunk trying to get some help by Nexa, but his teammate is dead, and Skrunk getting tagged through the smoke. He has to do this all by himself. Skrunk is in the smoke. They expect it. He's getting tagged and burned by a Molotov. He's still going to find Smiley. Sykin is now with him on the side and with the smoke.
Oh, man, what
he's
a reaction.
He's going to get MBK. What is this? Skrunk going huge for his team. Alamat now has to do this clutch. He's done so much for his team. And not even Alamat will be able to take that clutch.
Not happening. Not with the AWP. As you said, the pressure was there. And the AWP is just not the greatest in this kind of situation. What a play from Skrunk. He was right at the edge of the smoke. He was going back and forth, and the guy above him was like aiming at him, was just tracing him down with a crosshair, but he just didn't manage to shoot him down, actually. He just tagged him a little bit.
So lucky, but still so well played. Euronix, we a lot of luck coming into play, but we can't take this away from them. An outstanding performance, despite Alamat, the star player of Vexed, doing a great job. The German machine, Euronix, they continued, and they showed that this was a statement. This wasn't only Playing Duck. When they destroyed Playing Ducks, it wasn't luck. They are continuing, and they are here to stay.
Yeah, and that's big. Let's take a look at the replays from this past map, where Vexed still remain at the bottom of the standings with 0-3 right now. That's also important to point out. They'll be playing another match really shortly. Euronix definitely getting up there in the rankings. So, there we are with the replays. Actually, pretty late into the map already right here as Nexa. An interesting kind of peek right here at Smiley. Managed to jump up on top of that box because oftentimes people make mistakes right here. Sometimes they don't manage to jump up that box. Sometimes they just fall down. And I was wondering if he's going to go for the shot mid-air or something, but he just managed to make the jump, so no problem.
Yeah,
very easy to kill. So that's quite nice, and that's a good match to watch. Definitely Vexed showing that they still got the fight inside of them. Unfortunately, they're not able to win, but then for Euronix, that's very lucky because they didn't kick off too well yesterday. No. Now is the time to try and catch up for Vexed. Already, it's kind of like late. But for Euronix, they can still make it. So that's good. And then, we don't have much time to linger on this map still, as we've got another match coming. And that's going to be another match of Vex, as I mentioned, where we will be tracing them down still throughout the day.
Yes.
So if you've got some good luck for Vex, then better transfer it over to them right now, because these guys, they better not be walking out of this group with zero wins.
No, I mean, they are probably already heartbroken after being one of the biggest names coming into the tournament and losing to these German new teams, relatively new rosters that nobody has heard of. At least I didn't hear of this before the tournament, and so many upcoming teams performing so well in this tournament. I think it's really good. I love to watch upsets, you know, the underdogs beating the overdogs, and this is really a tournament where we so far have been showcasing a lot of these newer teams looking to climb up the ladder.
Yeah, so we'll see what more is in stock for this tournament, but finally we caught up with the schedule. So, that's going to be a little bit of a break right now, and we'll be back as soon as possible.
Indeed.
All right.